New details tonight on how authorities cracked a 50-year-old murder case in Dunn County, Wisconsin. Mary Schlace was 25 years old when she was stabbed to death in 1974, trying to hitchhike her way from Minneapolis to Chicago for an art show. The case has haunted her family and sheriff's investigators for decades, until last week when they arrested a suspect in Owatonna. Renee Cooper is live in the newsroom with more on the new technology it took to finally solve this case. Renee.
Lindsay, experts today calling this new genetic genealogy technology the most powerful investigative tool developed since the dawn of DNA testing nearly 40 years ago. It's brought closure to this case and sparked hope for many more grieving families behind unsolved cases. The suspect, John Miller, now behind bars awaiting his day in court.
He did inform us that as soon as he had opened the door, he knew why we were there.
Dunn County investigator Dan Westland reliving that long-awaited moment last week when investigators took 84-year-old John Miller into custody, 50 years after he suspected of stabbing Mary Schlace to death, leaving her body on the side of the road.
Mary can be remembered as an accomplished artist, equestrian, sister, aunt, and daughter.
Good afternoon.
Schlace's family in the room on Monday as investigators were joined by experts in investigative genetic genealogy, or IGG, from Ramapo College in New Jersey.
We have a number of people to thank.
They began a pro bono partnership on the case just last year.
It takes a village to solve a case like this.
As the experts explain, it was DNA scraped from a stocking cap left behind at that February 1974 scene that ultimately brought investigators to Miller. But the technology to connect those dots only came online in the last couple of years with IGG.
And new leads were developed.
Which uses a combination of DNA and genealogy to reverse engineer a family tree.
It's a lead that we turn over to law enforcement, like someone calling into a tip line.
Working through relatives until, together, they narrowed it to Miller.
Although this case is very old, at this agency it's never collected dust. We have talked a lot about the facts of this investigation, those involved, and what it took to resolve this case. But we don't want to forget that this is about justice for Mary and bringing her family closure.
Now, according to the criminal complaint, Miller ultimately admitted to investigators that the stocking cap was his and that he must have lost it during the homicide. Miller faces a first-degree murder charge. A court date has not yet been set. In the newsroom, Renee Cooper, 5 Eyewitness News.